I was up visiting Mumia yesterday, and when I came home, when I left the prison, I was speechless. Johanna and I went up last week to visit him, and just to make sure, we knew he's sick, and he's getting sicker every day. When Mumia walked off a death row, and we did that event at the Constitutional Center, we knew then that Mumia's life was more danger then than when it was on death row. These people don't like to lose. And also, while we're doing one thing, it was far advanced of us, and because people were so happy to get him off a death row, missed the point. We were supposed to bring him home that day, and we wasn't supposed to pause at all. Because we did pause and was happy with a fake victory, and the only victory we could have is bring him home and other political prisoners home. And when Mumia first got real sick the last time, we didn't know what we were looking at. We saw certain things that was happening to him. We saw his skin change. We saw his feet swell. We saw, different things happening. And we got diagnosis on it. So we fought for hepatitis C, which they said we would never get. And because it was $1,000 a pill, and we had to take it for 90 days, we won that. Not only did we win it for Mumia, but we won that for other prisoners. So the hepatitis C, they get the hepatitis C cure. They say that he's cured of it. But what we're seeing is the exact same thing that started him being sick the last time is quickly coming, and Mumia's feet is so swollen he can't get them into his shoes, into his sneakers. And when he walked in there, he's always trying to put on a big thing, for people. When he walked in, I was messed up because I knew what I saw. And then sitting there talking with him, he began coughing, right? And when he coughed, he would grab his side. And and you could see the pain in his face. So he said he thinks it's something in his lower lung and also his liver. And they gave him cirrhosis of the liver. And I'm gonna talk more about that, upstairs, and people are coming upstairs. But I'm telling you, I was so messed up. I started talking about it a few times, and then I couldn't talk about it no more last night. And but we gotta talk about it. They are slowly, Mumia said they moved him to slow death row. It's slow, torturesome death row. He said he burns on the inside all the time. It was cold in the visiting room. But Mumia was like this, and I was asking questions. He said, but I'm hot on the inside. And but it was this coldness out there. Just looking at Mumia was just horrifying, because I can see him quickly, not slowly, because he's much worse than what it was when we saw him last week. And he was worse than when Dr. Joseph Harris and Mark Taylor saw him on Saturday. And they didn't see what I saw. And I could tell because it wasn't written in the notes or the information that went out. He didn't know about the feet had swelled and the ankles had swelled unbelievably within 2 days, 3 days. And the coughing and the holding of the side, that wasn't there. They gave him cirrhosis of the liver. And and everything that they're doing promotes something worse, in him. January 17th, there's a court case. And they say, Mumia needs to see you in court. I know I'll be there. The question is, will you? Do you understand that these people are killing Mumia? And not only Mumia, they're killing a lot of political prisoners, a lot of people that are not considered political prisoners, within the prison system. And but I think that everyone inside them prisons are political prisoners. And they're political prisoners of war. There are some, but each and every last person is a victim of what you've been teaching today. So we're asking people to get on the bus, January 17, 2018, at 8 a.m. What is it, 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. We're leaving at 5:30 a.m. 147 West 24th Street. When people came to Philadelphia, when this first happened, the courtroom was full, the hallway was full, outside was full, and the judge felt the power of the people. So that's why we got to fill that place up. The hallways, the courtroom itself is a rather small courtroom. And we want to fill that. We want to fill the hallway. We want to fill the outside. They have got to see and feel the pressure of the people. So we can't have a little bit of people here. I'm saying we got to arm ourselves any way necessary to get this job done and settle all of it. For other people.